In August 2018, I made a decision. I decided that I was going to film my first ever video. So where would I choose? What location would I be in for this monumental event? Would I hire out an office space to create a professional looking setting? Or would I go outside and have a view of Glasgow in the background? No, I filmed it in my car. My Corsa, to be precise. And what I want to do today is show you this video and also share with you what I learned from filming that video and how I've evolved over time. So here is the video. It's about a minute in length. And while you're watching it, weigh up what you think was done well and what potentially could be improved. So what is Confidence by Design? Confidence by Design is a company which specializes in two key areas: enhancing public speaking skills and building self-confidence. Every week, I'm going to post content on these two areas. Sometimes this will be footage from my presentations. Other times it'll just be me speaking like this. But every time, you will leave with knowledge which will help you speak in a confident and captivating way. This will allow you to ace job interviews, kill presentations, and will give you courage which you didn't even know you had. So if you want to increase your self-esteem, if you want to end your fear of speaking in public, and if you want to develop yourself, then invest in yourself. Like this page and let me help you. So there it is, my first ever video. Now, I would love to tell you that it took me one attempt to create that, but it didn't. It took about 27 attempts of sitting in a stationary Corsa. Nevertheless, let's analyze this video together now. So the positives. Well, one thing I did do well is I had a clear message with that video. It was telling people what my company was going to do, what types of videos I was going to post, and why it is important to the viewer. And that's something I highly recommend you doing for your videos. You want to make sure you've got a purpose, a point to make, so that you're giving value to your audience. Another thing which I did do quite well was I used the word you a lot. I spoke to one person because I knew that there would only be one person on the other side watching that video. This personalizes it a little bit more, and you, see I'm using it again, should think about using that in your videos as well. So the third positive is good, but it's also bad at the same time. Let me explain. So this video was interesting. It did hold your attention, and that's because I used quite good body language and also varied my voice. However, it also sounded a little bit robotic. If you watch it back, it does sound a little bit scripted, and that's because it was. I wrote a script out word for word, and like I said, I practiced it 27 times until I had a take I was happy with. And you could feel that lack of authenticity in the video. It wasn't flowing, it wasn't conversational like this video is right now. So my tip is, do not get locked in, fixated on a script. Allow yourself to be more free and be more conversational so that you can build a real connection with your viewers. Other things which could be improved? Well, the use of the word kill.
Kill.
I don't think you should ever use the word kill in a video. My lighting could have been improved as well. Should have parked the car in a different place. And maybe just don't film in a car, Kyle. But look, you've got to start somewhere. And the reason I wanted to create this video today was to really demonstrate that you don't have to have everything perfect to get started. You just have to get started and you will learn and develop on the go. Now, if you don't even know where to start, I am holding a course on speaking to camera, creating compelling video content very soon. If you'd like more information on that, there is a link in the description of this video. Click on there and you'll get all the information you need, and hopefully I'll be able to see you on the course and help you as much as I possibly can. Now, let me leave you with this. If you're on the edge and you're not sure whether you should post a video or not, here's what I have to say. Do it. Worst case scenario, no one sees it. No
and so my first video. But best case scenario, you might just make a difference to someone watching.